They started full blast firing at us. And as luck would have it, it hit on my helmet. As a leader, you have to sometimes have to put your own life in danger to save your jawans. Surgical strike, which happened on 29 September 2016. I was one of the part. If you're a leader, then you have to train yourself, you have to gain experiences, you have to work hard, you have to have a relation with your troops who believe in you. If you have the capability and you are willing to work hard, then there is nothing impossible for you to achieve. And if you put it into my context, see, I have risen from second lieutenant, that's the smallest rank, to the highest rank of lieutenant general. After lieutenant general, there is only one rank, that is general. So it is a big and successful journey, I must say. I come from a very small village, from the Vidarbha region of Maharashtra, which is actually a drought prone and a very backward village. In my village, that time, what used to happen? A four standard, there used to be district level scholarship. And it was said that if you pass this scholarship, then this you are supposed to be very good. And in my village, nobody has passed till then. So my teachers saw potential in me. He said, this boy must appear for this. So he told my father, let him prepare for this scholarship. And I started preparing. So in between, there a circular came for admission to Saini School Satara, which is the only unique school in Maharashtra. It is a very good school. In fact, I must say that the alumni of my school was Air Chief Marshal Nayak, the film industries, Rakesh Roshan, and many of the officers, armed forces officers, have passed through the portals of my school. So it's one of the very good school. And to go to Satara from my village took 3 days. I did not know that. My headmaster told my father, just to prepare for this boy for the scholarships exam, let's try him out for this, so that it helps him to prepare for the scholarship exam. So I appeared for it, I passed it and went to the school, and then the whole life changed. So whatever I am today, it's because of my school. As a leader, now what do we have to do? And I will give one example of 1988, in which we had kind of captured a Pakistani post, went in about 10-15 kilometers, actually it was shown in our area, but we went and captured it. So, and we kept on holding on to that post. That post is still with us today. It is known as Papa Post. So, one day, when we were about 58 of us, I was a company commander, the Pakistani sniper hit one of my soldiers and hit in his head. And he was bleeding profusely and he had to be evacuated. And evacuation, nobody could go near him because everybody was firing there. And if you were not evacuated, then there was a problem. Then you would have died and there was a low morale. And everybody said, if I am hit, and I am going to die. So therefore, we had to take a chance. I, before that, never wore a helmet on my post. So that day, I don't know what happened. I just said that I wore a helmet. And I told my next officer, there was a subedar. I said, Saab, humko isko madad karna padega. We have to run from this post to another stone. So that a distance about 50 meters, and the Pakistan will see us and they'll fire at us. That much time will be, they will allow this sipai to go back. The Pakistanis were quite surprised. The halfway when we went, they started full blast firing at us. And as luck would have it, it hit on my helmet. The bullet hit on my helmet, was embedded in my helmet. It did not hit my forehead. And the Pakistanis, they did not fire there. The jawan was evacuated and he was saved subsequently. And I also, by the destiny, I can say, I was also surprised. That helmet is still there in my unit with the bullet embedded there. So as I said, as a leader, you have to sometimes have to put your own life in danger to save your jawans. And as a result of that, that post was maintained, held, and still is with us. Again, I say, we have to see your sixth sense. In Baramula, I used to go for an ambush or go for a terrorist encounters. And I used to normally follow the same route which I used to take, my whole company, because it's an easier route. And we had killed about 22 terrorists. And my unit had killed about 100 of them. So they wanted to teach us a lesson. And they're always wanting to ambush us. And they knew that in one of the villages, we always rest while coming back. So after one of the encounters, it just hit my mind, we'll not take the same route. So I told my company, boys, we will not go from this route, we will go a different route. That day, we did not stop in that village. We came back and later we learned that there are about 100 terrorists waiting for us and to ambush us. And unfortunately, there was another patrol of border security force. We went there and they got ambushed. So again, as a result, what was their intuition? A sixth sense. What I say about sixth sense? What is sixth sense? It is a combination of your experience, your hard work, your way of knowing the things, studying the things. So all this combines into making a sixth sense. And the leaders must have the sixth sense. In fact, if you put in today's language, it says that it goes into your subconscious, and then subconscious tells you this. So therefore, your experience, hard work, and little bit of luck makes you into having that sixth sense. Surgical strike, which happened on 29 September 2016. I was one of the part. Out of two parts in Jammu region, I was in charge. I was core commander of a corps which was responsible for three strikes. And what was more important? There are two ingredients. One was surprise. So when the decision was taken to launch surgical strike by the highest authority, that is the Prime Minister of India, then we were given about 8 to 9 days. And we were ready because we are already trained, we had rehearsed, we knew this kind of operation, we are ready. So we did it in 8 to 9 days. What most important was the surprise. And only 8 to about 10 people knew. In fact, my deputy who was there, he did not know. Next day when the surgical strike took place, he came to me and said, "Sir, has this happened?" I said, "If it's there in the TV, then definitely it would have happened." So I want to say that nobody knew all this thing, only 8 to 10. Therefore, it was successful. So what important is that surprise is the main element. Secondly is the timing. How did we select the timing? You almost, if you see yourself and go back and think, when is the man in a deepest of slumber? It's between 3 to 4 o'clock. Therefore, it had to be between 3 to 4 o'clock. And second, personally for me, and I believe in all religions, and that day, the Fajr namaz, the first namaz of the day, was after 4 o'clock. So therefore, I said that if anyone is praying, we should not kill him that time. And therefore, I said my target should be destroyed before 4 o'clock. And therefore, to keep the religious sentimentalities in mind, I decided it has to be about 3:30. I was a major general. You must have heard that Anantnag, Pulwama, Shopian, I was in charge of all the South Kashmir area, and we had killed about 55 terrorists. All top leadership was finished. And you will see in during 12-13, there was hardly any terrorist activity, which you now see. And therefore, they were quite disturbed. And they sent me a message in one of the written form. I never told anyone that they will, before I go out from, they'll knock me off. And I was, when I handed over that day, my flight was 1:30 to Mumbai. I had to leave at 11 o'clock. Everybody knew that. But at 9 o'clock, one of my friends who was commanding a unit in airfield, he told me, "Sir, we have never visited. Why don't you come and visit me?" So I said, "Okay." So instead of 11, I left at 9 and went there. When I boarded the aircraft, I came to that 11 o'clock. The gate which has to pass was ambushed, and three jawans of CRPF were next door. They were killed. Here again, divine intervention, I was saved. So you have to say, as a leader, you have to take your chances. You have to be, you have to have a help from the Almighty. And if you work towards that, I think the help will come your way. The message I want to give as a leader, and I can say where I achieved, is that if you have the capability and will to work hard, I am sure there is nothing going to stop you from achieving your goal which you set in your life. Now, secondly, if I have to say that if you are a leader, then you have to train yourself, you have to gain experiences, you have to work hard, you have to have a relation with your troops who believe in you, and you are also willing to die for them and lead them with the equal amount of danger they have. Thank you very much. It's been great interacting with you. All the best, and my compliments for your better future. Thank you very much.
Tell us what you think about this video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.